What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Ecola Espresso, and welcome to today's video. Now, today, we're going to be doing another gun breakdown. Today, we have a brand new weapon for you guys, and that is the Ripper. Now, before we get too far into this video, I just want to say, as usual, if you're on Carnage, come check out my channel down in the description below. If you're on my channel, go check out Carnage. That link will be down in the description below as well. So, getting right into the weapon itself, some quick little notes on the gun. It was part of the Devastation DLC pack, which hasn't yet come out, but it was released to the Xbox Season Pass holders early this past week, March 6th. So it's a very unique weapon in what we've seen so far in Call of Duty. And what I mean by that is the fact that it's not an AR, it's not an SMG, but rather it's a both. It's a true hybrid weapon that you can switch on the fly, and that feature alone gives it so much more dynamic to the gun itself. It's fairly easy to control, and it has good mobility, so it can be very dependable. Now let's move on to the stats. I don't have the PC code for this, so I can't give you the exact numbers. All this is based off of testing that I did previously with the weapon itself in private matches and all that. So the damage is a 2-4 shot kill. This is a little bit different when you think about it in terms of an AR from what we normally see with assault rifles, but it's compensating for the fact that it is a hybrid and that it can do both SMG and long range assault rifle kills. Now the SMG close range is 3 shots, mid range is 4 shots, and long range is 5 shots. The 5 shot though is only on occasion. Now if you're only talking about headshots, close range is 2 shots, mid range is 3 shots, and long range is 3 shots as well. So clearly, and as common sense dictates, headshots are awesome to go for and can help you out tremendously in gunfights. Now, with all that being said and contributing to it, the final thing I'm going to say about the SMG is the fact that the time to kill is a 0.11 seconds. Now, moving over to the other side of the coin, the assault rifle has a close range damage of 3 shots, mid range of 3 shots, and a long range of 4. Now, if you're speaking of headshots, then that would change these numbers to close range of 2, a mid range of 3, and a long range of 3. So, that in itself does some damage and can rip your opponents apart. Now, keeping symmetrical with the SMG, the time to kill is a 0.15 seconds. Now, moving on to the multipliers, the head is a 1.5 times multiplier, the chest is a 1.1 times multiplier, and the body is a standard 1.0 times multiplier. Now, the range, though I haven't pulled the game code like I said earlier, the two guns seem very similar to the Bison and the SA-805. The SMG, the 2-shot kill range is right around the 10-meter area, and the 4-shot kill range is a 17-meter area. Now, the AR, it moves over to the 3 shots at 25 and a 4-shot kill at 40 meters. Now, the standard mag size is 32 shots. You can find yourself needing to reload a bit with the higher fire rate that this gun offers. So, 32 shots may not end up being enough for you. The rate of fire for this, as an SMG, is 900 RPM. That is the third highest of the SMGs, only behind the CBJ, MS, and the Bison. So, use that to your advantage how you will. I didn't quite yet figure out the exact number in which rapid fire brings the SMG rate up to, but the AR goes from a 600 RPM to a 720 with the rapid fire selected. Now, if you do not have rapid fire on, that brings the AR rate of fire down to the second lowest of all the assault rifles, only behind the MSBS, which is a burst. So, if you want to put it that way, it realistically is the slowest of all the automatic assault rifles. Now, moving into the reload speeds, the empty reload speed is 3 seconds flat, a full reload speed is 2.7 seconds, and a cancel is 1.8 seconds. As always, sleight of hand is going to help you out with those speeds, but these are pretty decent for gunfights that you could be getting into with the Ripper. So, the ADS time is a standard SMG time of 0.2 seconds, and the recoil is moderate as an SMG and low as an AR. As always, grip is an option for this, and when running an SMG, be sure you aim a tad lower than you intend to hit. Lead your shot a little bit. The recoil will pull you up and to the right with this, so the iron sights can be a pain, but like I said, leading your shot can help. The assault rifle side of it, it's not that noticeable. It is quite low with the AR selected, and it is a relatively stable and easy to control recoil when you do. Grip isn't even that necessary when you have the assault rifle selected. So that about does it for the stats of this weapon. Now, as always, we're going to close out with the things to run and my personal preference on the weapon. So the things to run, I would say muzzle brake and or grip. Those things are kind of interchangeable. You can determine which one you need on your class based on your preference. Rapid fire, though the gameplay doesn't show it off at all, I played around with it after getting the gameplay for this gun, and it is absolutely amazing. Yes, you burn through ammo pretty quickly with it, but it helps tremendously, especially in close quarters gunfights. Now, another thing I would run is definitely Scavenger. Your ammo will definitely need refilled if you plan on staying alive and not running fully loaded. Now, another thing that I would also highly recommend is equipping running perks. And what I mean by that is like marathon agility, all those kind of things. This gun's mobility plays perfectly into a running gun gameplay style that a lot of people like to have. And me personally, I think it's amazing with running classes on. So equip those if you want to keep going and running and going right through your enemies as quickly as possible. Now, my personal preference, I was not a fan of the idea of gun DLC at first, but this weapon kind of redeems my thoughts on that. This weapon seems to be very balanced, especially if you're on a good connection, and then at that point, it even turns over to be OP if you have the jump up on people because of your connection. This weapon feels perfect to run with my playstyle. I love to run and gun, get up in the objective play. It may not pay off KD-wise sometimes for me, but as I previously mentioned, it is perfect for running and getting in the faces of your enemies. It's a very versatile weapon, and I would highly recommend it. So that's all there is. My name has been Nicola Espresso. That's been my time, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did like the video, please leave a like ring down below. Any shares to your Facebook, Twitter, and or MySpace if you're OG like that are always greatly appreciated. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe for the best of Call of Duty content. I have a ton of stuff still coming to you guys. Like I said earlier in the video, if you're on Carnage, please come check out my channel down in the description below. It always helps out and is much appreciated. If you're on my channel, go check out Carnage down in the description below as well for my video description. Anyways, that's been my time, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you guys once again so much for watching. My name is Nicola Espresso. As always, I hope you guys have a great day. I shall see you guys later. Take care and peace.